Hi and welcome back. In the last video, I showed you how to create your Shopify Partners account. So in this video, let's do a brief dashboard overview of what we have here. So I'm assuming you're a complete beginner. That's why I want to do the overview. Here under development stores, this is where you're going to create the stores, and this is what I will be working with. So if I click here, you'll see that you can create a store. You can create a store. And once you create the store, it will just be a normal store like any other Shopify store, and you can build it and even show it to people. If you want to sell it, you can show it to people and they would see the store and decide if they want to buy it, or you can just have the store and sell your products. So it will be a live store that you can use to sell products up to about 50 orders, and you can create as many of them here on your development stores. And then we have this option of managed stores. So let's say you're a freelancer and you may need to request people for permissions on their stores. So if you come here under manage stores, you can just get the link of that store that you want to request permission for, and you can add a client store here. And once you input the link of the store, you can request the permissions that you want for that store. If you want to add a message, you can add a message there, save, and then the owner of the store will receive an email of your request and they can allow you to manage their stores. So if you're a freelancer, this is something you're going to use. So that's about managed stores, and you can have as many of them as you want to. If you're a freelancer, you may have many stores that you manage for other people, and this is where you'll do it. And then referred stores, if you've referred certain stores here, this is where you're going to see the stores that you've referred. So if you also decide to take part in the Shopify affiliate program, then this is where you're going to see any stores that you've referred to Shopify. And then you also have affiliate tools. So these are tools that you can use. You can get the link, your affiliate link, and then market that on your website, your blog, your social media accounts, and so much more. So you'll have to apply here if you want to become an affiliate for Shopify. And then apps, if you want to build apps, this is where you'll go. You'll find beginning documentations here, and you can also create themes, okay? So let me just click on themes, and you'll see that you can start by submitting a theme if you already have a theme, and you can learn how to build themes. And then apps, you can create an app using the Shopify API. If that's something that you're interested in, you can learn how to do that here as well. There are very good tutorials how to do it here. And then payouts, these are if you're an affiliate and an app and you have certain apps, you have themes, this is where you can change those settings for your payment. And then education, as the name suggests, you're going to get starting materials to help you here. You can get documentations here if you need help with the API, all that you can get here under documentation. And then if you need help, you can go under support, you can send an email, you can create a ticket, and you can chat with the Shopify support team. And then team, so this is for you. If your Shopify Partners account is used for managing stores, you may need to add a team. Maybe you have a couple of people that you work with, or you even want to add your other email as a security feature. You add another email so that if you forget your first email, you can use that second one to log in. So that's something you can do here. Team, under team, invite owner, just enter your email address. Follow the steps there. And if you want to add staff members, so maybe you have managed stores, you have certain stores that you manage. You want to add staff so that they can have a look at those stores for you. Then you can add staff members. And then settings, this is where you can change your partner account settings. So if you come here, you can see you can edit your information here. And that's pretty much it for this video. So in the next video, let's see how you can create your first development store. So I will see you in the next video.